when we're looking at turkey habitat, I always get the question, you know, where does a turkey nest? Number one, they nest on the ground. Number two, a turkey nest is not that elaborate. They pretty much find a low spot. They don't like a lot of overhang or overstory directly over the nest. So they need, that hen needs a spot that she can kind of get down in a little hole, lay the eggs, and she can stand up and walk out of. And she has to be able to stand up once those poults hatch out and lead those poults out. Poults aren't, when they're born, they're not much bigger than a baby chicken. So anything about this big, it has to hatch out and be able to walk through that forest floor. If it can't negotiate, you know, if the vegetation that's around it, if there's a solid mat of vegetation, that's going to inhibit those poults from moving. You see in this area, I mean, it is being managed purely for wildlife. This is, livestock is not a top priority, but we've got, you know, a lot of browse species with the beautyberry. We've got a lot of dewberry or rubus species. And all of this, turkeys will feed on all this. And what we're looking at, you know, we were talking about nesting, you know, in areas that they're going to nest, sometimes on these edges, sometimes, you know, out underneath certain clumps of trees, they don't really want to have, you know, covered directly over them. They have to be able to get up and walk out of that stuff. But a lot of times when they put their nest, it's going to be within 100 yards of some sort of opening that that hen can take those poults to for brooding. During this time of year, you know, late summer to late spring, you want to have some viable visibility out there to about 50 to 60 yards. It doesn't have to be clear like a park, but you need to be able to kind of be able to see that far in that vegetation. And what that translates into in the wintertime is about 70 to 80 yards that that turkey can utilize that. Anything thicker than that, the mortality rate on the turkeys goes up drastically. So if it's thicker than that, predators can get to them quicker. Okay, here we are in a forest that we're trying to manage for the turkeys. This one, prescribed fire, they have applied prescribed fire as a management tool in this particular location. But I want to keep in mind that prescribed fire is a tool, and it's not always the best tool to use. In this situation, you can see there is some greenery, some browse and forb production, but it doesn't have the vegetative response that we're looking for. This should be a lot more. And the reason for that is in this particular area, and it kind of holds true all over most of this Northeast Texas area, you get into what's called canopy closure, where the oak trees and some of the pines, they're growing at such a high density, it inhibits sunlight from getting to the forest floor. Well, that inhibits your understory growth. And most of our wildlife species, including turkey, are dependent on that understory growth. So in this situation, prescribed fire is not going to be maybe the best tool to use to try to rehabilitate this land. It can be used, but it's going to be a slow road. A better tool is to consider a wildlife thinning, either a diameter cut, what's called a D plus 6, a D plus 9, where you take the diameter of the tree, you add 6 or 9 to it, and everything within that amount of feet you take out. And essentially, it cuts out everything within that tree's drip line. And what that does, it frees up the resources, all these saplings that are competing with these large trees. It frees up all those resources and you get increased mass production. In this particular spot, there were livestock once upon a time. And they kind of kept the understory at bay. They were grazing in the woodlands, which we don't normally encourage that except on a prescription basis. You know, letting livestock graze in the woods at certain times of the year and then pulling them out before spring green up, because they do compete with our native wildlife species. But here it actually worked to our benefit. And they actually kept the understory kind of at bay. And by coming in and applying prescribed fire back into the landscape, we have achieved much of that savanna style overstory, where you have the hardwoods, either the pine or the oak overstory, and then we have that grassy understory with a few browse and a few forbs. There's a lot of visibility here. Turkeys can negotiate this quite easily. You know, proof is in the numbers. This is probably the one part of the property they have the most turkey activity, as well as the most deer activity. But this is ideal habitat. It's kind of a good way to have a snapshot of what you want your property to look like in terms of turkey management.